Is it Captain Blush or what?
Yes.
I mean, hey, look at the size of this box here. The first thing. Friends, salute. Today I'm saluting like this. Salute. Well, I'm saluting like the Royal Air Force say, and welcome to Patricic Bros RC Reality Without Editing. Now that means that on this channel, we will try to film and test as many different RC planes as possible while we're filming. All of that from an amateur point of view and, of course, without editing. What you see is what you get, and this is the true life of the modder. Now, I can tell you, and Captain Blush, of course, we can tell you from our experience that this is really the best hobby in the world. I can't imagine better. And today we have something so special that this is unbelievable. Of course, you have seen already on the title of the video, you can see it here. Today we have something so interesting because
this is the biggest box ever, eh?
Hey, the bigger the box, the better. But the point is that the unboxings are so special, and today it will be really more special because we have the iconic jet plane from the Second World War. Now, already you know that EDF planes are my passion, I just love, and I would love to have every single one, and of course even more if they are from the Second World War, because there weren't much of EDF, I mean, of the jet planes back then.
Yes.
Now, we all know, if you are following our channel, you all know that for me, there is one jet, the most beautiful of all times, and it doesn't matter in what kind of version, if it was the real one, or if it was the foam version now, and that is the iconic Messerschmitt 262.
Yes.
This was the first jet fighter during the Second World War by the Luftwaffe. It was in the combat late at the end of the war. I mean, for me, this is really, this design is, it was so way in front of its time that it is unbelievable. If you just look at it, I mean, look at this, eh? Look at this sexiness. And if I show it like this, I always say that this one really reminds me of a shark. And look at this now.
Mm-hmm.
Look at this, eh? And I have got the comments that in the Germans, in fact, they were making the not just the planes, also the vehicles, and I don't know what, they were observing real animals in the real life and then using that design even in the machinery. And you can see here that this effect is the silhouette of a shark, eh? Now, of course, everybody is talking about the Messerschmitt 262 because this was, of course, like we have said, the first jet fighter during the Second World War, way in front of its time. I mean, can you imagine how scary it must have been if you were flying the piston-driven plane and all of a sudden you have seen this silhouette on the sky coming and you didn't know what the hell is this, eh? It was like an alien ship, eh?
Yes.
And even this ominous ship, I mean, this was really scary. But of course, there is the second plane, the second jet plane during the Second World War, which is really overlooked. So today we will pay attention to the second one, and we have it here. Thanks to God that the Dynam, I will put this little baby here, which still needs to be do the maiden flight. And the second plane that is, like I have said, that it's overlooked, and the Dynam, they thanks to God to them, I will salute them because they have chosen this plane to make from a foam, so we can have the experience of flying this one. And this was the Royal Air Force answer to the Messerschmitt 262, and this is the Gloster Meteor.
Yes.
Now look at this, eh? Again, you have the design of the plane with double the motor, say, I mean, it looks amazing. And right now, at this point, I can tell you and I can recommend you this plane that it will fly good. Why is that? Because I already have a plane like this in my hangar.
Can't you unbox it?
Yeah, I'll unbox it. I'll just say a few things. I will be short, eh? We already have a plane like this because in the past they have released this plane, but it was powered on the 4-cell batteries. But this now is the new version, they upgraded to 6-cell. Now, can you imagine this? Now, I was also flying my version, the previous one on 4-cell. Later, we have upgraded that plane with the engines from the Messerschmitt that I crashed. Now, can you imagine the crashed Messerschmitt borrowed its engines to the Gloster Meteor?
Yes, transplantation.
Yeah, but of course, today we have the option for this. Now, just a few historical words about this. This was the first time tested in
1943. Nah. 5th of March 1944.
That was the first time that was the first flight of this plane was in 1943. The first time it was engaged in the combat was in 1944. Of course, this was again at the end of the war. It didn't saw much action. But in fact, it was the answer to the Messerschmitt. If the war was going to be a little more, year or two, even after the 1945, they would play a big role, this one and that one, I think, in the future fights in the air. But of course, luckily the war ended, so that's it, the end of the story. But I will tell you that in fact, at the beginning, maybe the Messerschmitt was superior to this one, but in fact, after the Second World War, I mean, I wonder why, but because I don't think that they were producing Messerschmitts anymore, this one in fact did set the first jet records in the speed.
Yes.
In 1946. It was flying over 900 kilometers per hour.
991 or 616
yes.
miles per hour.
And can you imagine that this plane was the first twin motor jet that set that record, and you don't see much people, even the RC pilots, talking about this. So today we will show you the option that you can click on, and like I have said, not just that we already have the plane like this in the full cell version that we have tested, I can tell you from the first hand that this plane is really flying good. I was really amazed on the maiden flight how easy this plane takes off and how easy it is to handle in the air. And finally, Captain Blush,
yes.
You will see how the plane looks.
Finally.
And the box, I mean, this is one of the biggest boxes that I have got the plane.
Wait.
Inside there.
No,
is
you
there
wait.
Any specification?
Yes.
Show the specification so that we don't have to tell you later. Like I have said, what is it? The wingspan, 1.27 meter wingspan, the fuselage length, it is in fact longer than wider. That's interesting, eh? But the point is that in this time, it also does have, I think that it has the, if I remember, yeah, it does have the flaps, the retractable landing gear, it has it all, but the point is that this is now upgraded version to the 6-cell, and can you imagine how much better sound the 6-cell will make? Now, are you ready to see?
There's nothing to see.
okay. We will still have to remove something. I will just put this here.
Ooh.
Captain Blush, eh? Well, let's see how it is packed, of course. Where is my knife? So I will be quick. I was again talking too much about the beginning.
Yes, I don't know why you have to talk so much.
You can fast forward.
Well, but can't you talk meanwhile?
But I must say a few words at the beginning, because every plane deserves to have at least few words, even more this one, because like I have said, it is really overlooked, this plane, eh? But it's so sexy. Of course, first, let's take out
the tail,
the elevator, or as we call it, the horizontal stabilizer. Eh? Now this one is sexy. Now you can see here, this is show the servo. These are now upgraded to the semi-metal.
No, it is metal, it's aluminum.
Aluminum.
Plastic, brass and aluminum, eh?
combined. It is combined. It's not just the plastic, but it is already have inside here the metal gears.
Look at this, eh? It's screwed to the other side, eh?
Yeah, of course. Now this is not just something to glue inside, and you can see here the ball linkages. Do you see this?
Yes.
Now they have refreshed this plane. It's really good. Even the first version with the paint job, I mean, it's really, really sexy. And can you imagine how sexy this is in the silver in the sky? I mean, like I have said, I can tell you right now that this is worth its money, eh? Of course, here you have the tail. Mm-hmm.
Open carefully.
I will open it here. The rudder. Now, of course, there will be some gluing involved, but don't worry, you can believe me that you will enjoy to glue this plane together. Because when you're assembling the plane, this is your first bond with the plane. The first one is when you're surprised, when you unbox it, but later when you're assembling the plane, I mean, this is, you have such a good time as the maiden flight, eh? Even more, because when you're assembling the plane, you know that you can't crash it, eh? But on the maiden flight, eh, yeah. It can be scary, eh?
Looks like a submarine, eh?
Hey, look at this, eh? Now, of course, you can see here, this will go inside. I will glue this, of course. Always remember, if you have a lot of paint here, don't forget to take it away, sand it maybe with something, or you just can put the duct tape on and just peel it quickly, and the paint will go away, but maybe not. Look, I can see here, I think that maybe this is the bolt construction.
Yeah, this is for this. Nah.
No, that one is here.
And maybe
because
the bolt
this one does have the T shape. Do you see this? Like some gliders.
Uh-huh.
Look how it was. Do you see this? Pretty interesting, huh?
And maybe this is bolt construction.
Hey. Yeah, this one for sure is. No, I don't remember anymore because I think it was a few years since we were assembling this plane for the last time. You have the rudder here. The servo is already pre-installed for you.
Ah, you see? The rudder servo is not going to work so much, so it's not Metal Gear.
Yeah, it doesn't have to be, because the rudder
is so small.
Usually you use the rudder only on the, I use it on the takeoffs and on the landings to approach the runway, but maybe with this one, because you can fly really slow this plane, I will use a little rudder in the turns. I mean, we will see, eh? But like I said, it's not so stressed. The rudder is never so stressed as maybe the ailerons and even more the elevator. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Oh!
The cockpit.
The cockpit.
Head
and
over.
Of course the pilot, because
and some Y cables.
There is not more silly thing than it's more here. Eh? Wait. There is so silly if you don't have the pilot in such a big plane. Of course you have here. Look, the carbon bars.
Mm-hmm.
We will see where that will go. I have really forgotten. Eh? Oh, the screwdriver.
Yes.
Because the good thing is that in fact. All that you need even to assemble the plane, the dyno will provide
I
you
think
with.
Even the glue,
and
yes.
Even the two glues. And these glues, it's interesting. In the past, I didn't ever assemble the plane with these glues. But then sometimes I ran out of foam tab glue, and then I was using these glues, and in fact, they work perfectly. As same as the foam tab. So maybe this plane, I will assemble with these glues. Say, there,
yeah, why
and
not?
They do work, eh? Of course, next thing, this box.
This is empty.
Sometimes the boxes are just to secure empty. The plane inside.
This, the bigger one is not empty, I think.
Ah, this one also has something inside. And these are, the fuel tanks.
Uh-huh.
You will see how sexy this will look, eh? And of course you have here, don't think that this is all that it was here. You see, this comes here on top.
Uh-huh.
Do you see this, eh? But this one doesn't move, do you see this thing?
Yes, only the bottom
part
moves.
This one is fixed rather. I will put it here and this one I think that you...
Bolt on also.
Yeah. Or maybe not. You just put inside here later the carbon bar and just stick it inside. But of course that is the instruction manual, which still is good enough so you can assemble the plane.
Yes.
You will find it later in the box. Like I have said, the top of the rudder.
Yes.
This, I mean, really, really beautiful.
Yeah, you glue this on.
Yeah, I think that you glue this on, but that means that you have to really tighten. I will see if I will glue it maybe or maybe not, because here you have the screws for this. This will be for later. I will tell you, of course, on the maiden flight, what I have done, and of course here you have, yes, you have the tips of the wings here, eh?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
The tips of the wings, right, left, you can see here also this is the bolt construction, do you see? Must open it first. These tips, you can bolt them on, so later you can store this plane like it is now with the motors, but you will make it easier for transport and for storage if you take away these parts of the wings.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
And even has the lights on. Do you see this kind of
Yes,
part?
I can see.
It does have the LED lights, LED, bolt together construction.
Uh-huh, right.
The second one, it also shows you where to put the fuel tanks. No, I just wonder if I will put them on or maybe not. I will see.
Fuel
I will
tanks.
See as I will go, but maybe I will make them in a way that you can remove them. You can just put the magnets in because it would be much easier If later you can remove them, because if nothing else, they will make certain drag when you will fly the plane. I mean, not much, maybe not much, because they are just two.
Left.
But if you have a lot of rockets or something sometimes under the planes, now that means that can make quite a lot of drag. Of course, we come here. Let's see this box.
Are there boxes inside the boxes, eh?
That is why it is so beautiful to open this dining planes, because there is a lot of boxes and surprises. This time it's empty boxes.
But there, still, is, there is something inside.
Nothing.
Air, air.
Air. But still, these boxes are really good. And you look, check this one, eh? Check this one. Don't just throw it away. You have really good box to store something. Maybe something that is left over from the previous assemblings, and you have it stored inside.
Yes,
here,
why not?
I don't want to have. I never throw these boxes away. I always save them. I have many, many in my hangar.
Quick guide.
Assembly guide, of course. All that you need is written here. The point is that you have here the travels. The travels, and that you have 12 blades, 70 millimeters, 80 amp. I think that this is still the old one. That this is the old, the CG is important. That is the yes. CG and the travels. But I know that this is the 6 cell, even though it says here, do you see this?
Yes, 4 cell.
It says 4 cell, but this is from the previous. I mean, they didn't print brand new just because to say here that it is 6 cell. But, you have here also in English.
What?
Like you can see, the only thing that you have to do is assemble this, the tips of the wing, the back, and this part here, and glue the canopy, and that's it. You're good to go, eh?
Yes. There are also the stickers inside.
Tomcat brush, that's okay. I will check what's inside. This is it. Yes. I hope that this is, it must be. It must be the
6 cell.
The 6 cell version, eh? I'm just wondering about the, because according to the KVs, you can check.
You will check that later, eh?
I will check later, of course I won't check now, but I will put the papers here. And of course, let's take out the best part of this. And this is the fuselage this time, which of course is almost in one piece, eh?
Yes, and it's very big.
Look at this, eh?
Oh, wait.
This is something to take out, eh? This is unbelievable, of course. Before I will put this away, I still have here, and now I know, Captain. Because I was wondering the first time, wait, I will be careful.
Yeah.
I have painted the first Gloucester just because I didn't know what the hell, what kind of stickers are these, because I can't put them on the plane, eh? And this time I will make totally the plane like it should be. Because these are the water decals.
Yeah, water transfer decals.
Water. But I didn't know in the past how to use them. Now what you have to do, I will tell you now if maybe, because I didn't know what to do with them. You cut the sticker out, approximately, and then you just put it in the hot water, in a warm water, wait a little, and the sticker will peel off from the bottom of this paper, and then you just take it carefully, put it on the plane,
and that's
go
it.
Go through with the cloth, dry it, and that's it, eh? Leave it to dry, and it's it. And it's really more, in fact, at the end, it is a little harder to put them on the plane, but at the end, it's so much more sexier, because it looks like it is painted on the plane.
Ah.
Way, way much better.
So the it also cannot peel off.
All is shiny, and you can see that there are stickers on the plane, eh? And now I will show you the bottom of the plane, look. The wheels.
Ooh. Aluminum.
Aluminum wheels.
Flaps.
You can see the sexy splat flips. The front wheel.
Front wheel, steerable.
The access to the motor, you can see it here.
Yes.
So you can take this off and you can get to the motors inside, eh? And of course, let's check inside the fuselage. Now I will have to put some.
Nah, you can open it like this now.
Yeah. You can open it like this. Let's check inside. The labels all.
Oh, look at the size of this wire, say.
Yeah, of course it is, say.
This must be 6S.
Yeah, of course it is. It's the EC5, which of course we have the 5000 milliamps batteries. And of course I will put all these cables in the back here.
put the receiver in, and you have the beautiful compartment for the battery. Now I just wonder if maybe what
I think that I will change this
straps.
I will see how.
No, but these secure. Are not. No, you can secure. Yeah.
Again, you have to peel. You have to. It's hard to. This is something that I don't like. It is hard to secure the battery with this. I think that I will put those that I can really. Pull good and then tie them in. I will think of something, but it doesn't matter right now. At this point, we can see that it is labeled like it should be. And I can see that this will run on 6 cell power. You can imagine this, eh?
Yes.
Of course, I will put here a little tape. So later you don't have to stick your finger inside and ruin it all. It's not hard. Just put a little duct tape here. Put it a little to the back and then you have something
that you can pull
the cockpit, eh? Ah, Captain Blush, eh?
Put it a bit together, eh?
I will put it a little together for the closure of the video, like this. I will put this on, because, of course, you will have to put yourself the cockpit on. You also have here a few cables. I have here the toilet, let's just check quick how it will look. It is still, it is the jet fighter pilot.
Yes.
And now it looks much better, huh, Captain Blush?
Of course it does.
Look at this, eh?
Perfect.
It looks alive.
You put this here.
Of course, here you have those.
Like this.
Carbon bars. Carbon bars. Wings. Yes. Of
course. Now you can put in the tail.
I will just put a little tail inside. Hey, huh? Mm-hmm. Now imagine this, I mean, it will look so sexy, believe me, my friends, once this plane is assembled, it's really, really sexy, and it's really, you will be in love all over again, I mean, look at this, tell me that this doesn't look good, and can you imagine this at low, slow passes, I mean, this will look really sexy,
Yes.
And, of course, you can see here, the tip of the nose is protected, so if you put it upside down, you won't ruin the nose of this plane.
Yes.
This is unbelievable. And what I have done on the previous one, you know what I have done on the first one?
Oh, the back.
I have even drilled the holes here, where the machine guns are, and I have put the black pipe, the black tube inside, that you have for the compressed air.
So for the cooling?
So I have the extra cooling from the battery and it really looks like the machine guns.
Maybe you can do this again, eh?
Maybe I will put them on this one. Because it does help to cool the battery down, eh?
Yes.
So this is it, what to tell at the end? Hey.
Well, there is something for you to do today.
Hey, I can't wait to start to assemble this, eh? And I'm really sorry that this plane is Gloster Meteor is so overlooked, eh? Because look how sexy it is, look how sexy.
But I think this is the only company that makes this, huh?
Yeah, I don't think that you can buy another, at least not in the foam version. And you will see now what this is. I will put it here. These are the two most beautiful and the most iconic jets for me. This is the father of all jets. And this is, how can we call this, eh?
The
we
cousin.
Can't call the mother. Cousin, the cousin. The cousin, the overlooked cousin, eh?
Yes.
But if you are a jet lover, and if you love this one, and if you have the Messerschmitt at home, then I think that you won't think twice. You will have the link below for this plane, eh? Don't think twice. Believe me that you will love this plane. And I can tell you, like I have said, I will even put the videos at the end of this video. You can check my maiden flight with this, eh? And the second flight with Messerschmitt engines on, eh? And you will see how sexy and how easy this plane is to handle in the air. It's unbelievable.
You have done the second flight with the Messerschmitt engines?
Yeah, but then later I have even transplanted the engine for the third time. I have put it inside the first one, the high-speed EDF units.
Oh.
But those we have never tested. I have just put them in, and since then the jet is waiting upstairs. To be, but maybe after this maiden flight, I will even take down again the first one, and I will fly that one with the high-speed EDF units. But that is what I have done in the past, because this was on 4-cell. But now the Dyna has done it for you. They have upgraded it, and now you already have the 6L power, and you don't have to worry about that. And we all know that 6S power with the 12 blades, I mean, that means a really good sound, even more if you have the 2 engine. So that's it, enough Captain Blush. Yes. Video a little bit long. Pilot Robert and Captain Blush signing off from Slovenia with beautiful and sexy Dynam Gloster Meteor 6L power, 12 blades. Don't wait to lock, click on something. You have the option here, you have the link here, or click on something else as long as you're clicking and you're having fun. Don't wait until tomorrow, you never know if tomorrow will come, so fly something today. If nothing else, take a piece of paper, make yourself a paper plane and have fun outside. Eh?
Yes.
but really, my friends, really. Eh? So this is the captain must be. Because what?
Assembling time.
Yes, I will assemble this plane today, but first after this filming, Captain Blush will show what he was doing for the last 2 days assembling the plane. But right now, Captain Blush don't show nothing, because beside that plane is the plane that viewers still don't know that exists, eh?
Yes.
And it will be restored pretty soon, eh? So this is it. Thanks again, just expect more, and I can't wait to see the man of flight with this one. This will be something, eh? Yes. And with this one, eh? Thanks.